the Tirpitz Museum holds three permanent exhibitions and the bunker, which you can enter from the museum. And I was curator for one of the other exhibitions called West Coast Stories. And I'm going to tell a little bit more about our thoughts and ideas planning the exhibition. West Coast Stories tells 20,000 years of local history from the Ice Age until modern time. And it tells about the Vikings, about strandings, and how people fought against nature in this area. And we have really a lot of tourists visiting Lovend every year. And they come to explore and enjoy the beach and the fantastic nature in the area. And many of them are not aware of all the stories that are hidden in the landscape around in the area. Some are hidden underneath the dunes, and some are just not obvious unless you know them. And the purpose of this exhibition was to make people go there and when they went out from the exhibition, they would go there and see the stories, and the exhibition will make the link between the local landscape and the stories they have heard, and so they can be inspired to explore the area in more depth. Prior to the both planning the museum and work and the exhibitions, we worked with user experience design. We wanted to give people the best experience, and therefore we looked at usability, accessibility, and how to make the visitors enjoy themselves. And we also investigated in different target groups and used them to define the story perspective, the design, the choice of stories, and the choice of learning styles for the exhibitions. And we made surveys of both existing visitors and non-visitors on the site. And we used them to define six different target groups in the three long-term exhibitions. And this was quite important, important work for us. They were very different visitor groups, but they were all on vacation. And they were having a social experience and hard-earned days with their families. By reaching out to these different groups of people and bring their experiences and ideas into the planning, we tried to make the archaeological and historical stories and objects more easily accessible to people who seldom visit museums. So the target group in this specific exhibition was people who not normally visit museums. And that was, of course, very ambitious. It was mainly families with younger kids that normally would go to adventure parks like Legoland, which is an hour drive away. It's not a public that looks for traditional object and text-based exhibitions. So how could we challenge that? One of the things that we were very much inspired by was Alex Burch, who is now at the National History Museum in London, who has introduced this term, "We are not visitors." And that became our mantra. We as professionals, we often assume that visitors have the same understanding as we have. We also assume that what is iconic to us is also iconic to the visitor. And we assume that they read all the text and that they stay in the exhibition for a very long time. But when you ask them, and when you walk around in the museum looking normally, it's not the case. Mainly they want a good experience. We also looked at different learning styles, and looked at George Heinz's learning styles. And for this exhibition, we focused mainly on the discovery way of learning, where you learn as you explore. Together with the designers, Tinka Imagineers, we made a Bible, or our Bible. And in this Bible, we wrote 15 commandments to keep us all in the same direction. And one of the commandments is this: we don't show objects just to show objects, but we show objects to tell stories. So the question was, how do we transform the material culture into something that people can relate to and find interesting? How can we make them feel that they are part of the story? How can we make it important to them? How do we get people, and in this case, tourists, to choose local history and other things such as other things such as amusement parks and etc., without making it too artificial and too shallow? Well, this target group is are used to explore, and to keep them interested, you need to capture their imagination. So we try to make an adventurous exhibition where the visitor can explore and dive into many of the most dramatic or surprising stories from the Danish West Coast. And I'm just going to show you a plan of the exhibition. In the middle, there is an old lifeboat that you can sit in. And around that, the designers made up the sand dune landscape. 20,000 years of history is a long time span. And people normally visiting museums, or not normally visiting museums, are not capable of learning all about it in just one museum visit. So we chose 14 of the most exciting stories which were hidden in this sand dune landscape, which gives a visitor a possibility to explore and seek for the stories themselves. Though the stories are presented as chronological, so you can walk through it and from the start to the end, but you can also just pick what you want. And each story is ended in itself. So you can choose. And each story has its own vitrine, a window, which tells the story in many ways, in many different ways. We have mechanical installations with the animations, and also the material culture. The objects are shown in different ways, and sometimes even in the installation itself. It's the object that makes the stories authentic. And we imagined before, actually, that we started to design the exhibition, that this exhibition would have the least number of objects. But as it turned out, it turned out to be almost the opposite. Stuffed with real stuff, people actually enjoy this room. And it appeals to them, to the non-experienced museum visitors, not because of the objects themselves, but because of the good stories, the animations and the mechanical installations that brings life into the displays. And I'm just gonna show you a small glimpse of it. This story is about the Vikings in the area, and it's a very specific location where they produced a lot of textiles, probably mainly for sale production. So in this vitrine, the real objects are linked to the story by an animation tapestry, yeah. Also, we don't have any text. People listen to the story by holding their audio guide to this little brick at the bottom. But all the objects, for all the objects, we have a small text, a small C text, that tell facts about the objects. So if you want to know more about the different objects, you can read the small plate. Yes. To give an overview of all these stories and of the landscape itself in the area, we made a small a table with an animation, a map table we call it, where you can see the development of the landscape and culture in the area. And quite early in the process, we decided to deselect touchscreens and instead use projections to give room for a more social experience. The digital technology is never up front, but it's used to support the storytelling. And actually, we have no cue in front of all these touch screens. And these projectors gives us possibilities to give the audience an almost real experience. They can take a journey in this rescue boat that is in the middle. And each half hour, the room gets dark and changes into a 4D video map show. And here you submerge into the West Jutland history, with mammoths, with high waves, sandstorms, and Vikings, and the objects that tell us, the archaeologists and creators, the stories they're used in the movie. And visitors actually discover the idea of letting the objects play a role in this grand story. And I'm just going to show you a small time lap of this film. Yes. And you might think this is overkill, but this is actually one of the things that visitors are most excited about in both this exhibition and the whole museum, because it captures their imagination, it touches their feelings, their emotions, and I think that is quite important when we have to reach out to people. So far we had, as Lynn told, 380,000 people visiting this museum since it opened in July last year, which is much more than we had hoped for. And many of them are actually visiting again because they haven't heard all the stories. In the museum, we have 4 hours. You can walk around and listen for more than 4 hours to stories. And also, it's something people really can relate. They listen to more than they normally would read. So we have learned a lot from this process, and I think the most important is to remember who are the visitors. Thank you.